You have been listening to fairy tales since childhood, and if you are an Indian, then you must have heard and know about Kali Mata. A Hindu mythological character represents how dangerous a woman can be in anger. If these two fictions are mixed in a usual horror film, you get a movie like Bulbul, a Hindi film released in Netflix. I am Shubhendu from S-Wood reviewing the film Bulbul, and I will give you my opinion about the film and a rating based on my point of view. So stay tuned till the last. But before we move forward, start with a spoiler warning. The story is from late 18th century when the little girl named Bulbul gets married to a man aged 5 times more than her in a Thakur family. At that time, India was under British control, so you can call the family as Zamindar. There were 3 brothers, where the youngest one named Satya is from her age. They too became friends and eventually grows up. For some reason, the younger brother went out of his palace and comes back after 5 years. But then, the people were afraid of a demon woman called as Churel in Hindi. This is a horror film but with a modern and an old touch of class. To know what happened after that, you have to watch the movie at Netflix. Talking about the casting in the lead role, Tripti Dimri as Bulbul and Avinash Tiwari as Satya. On the other main role, Rahul Bose, Pauli Dam and Paramrata Chattopadhyay. Film is directed and written, or rather I would say well written, by Anvita Dutt, produced by Anushka Sharma and Karnesh Sharma. The story revolves around the character Tripti, and she is awesome. Completely does justice to her character. You can feel the pain behind her facial expression. The film is about her, her mental condition during different phases of the film. Avinash as Satya also too good. Though the film is about Bulbul, you can associate and relate to Satya. At some point of time, you start to think from his point of view. Sometimes the story lets you quit the film, but Avinash keeps you engaged in. Rahul Bose is impressive again. How he hides his anger as well as his feelings, and how he expresses that at the end tells you about how the demon is in their human form. Paramrata, excellent as usual. You cannot decide whether to assume him as villain or hero. Hindi film industry is dying to get some actors like him. Pauli Dam is good, well, but she got less screen time. Talking about plot, if you want to see a scary ghost with a lots of makeup, this is not for you. From first to last, you believe in the demon woman. It has twist, but not like that you cannot understand and goes over your head. The last 40 minutes clarifies the hype created over time. You get a clear picture of what is happening and why is happening. The background music is too good, and sometimes the cinematography takes the film to a higher level. The film is based in a Bengal region, so that the simplicity of Bengal people at tradition gives you a treat to your eyes. The way they dresses and their jewelry makes it a complete epic. Dialogue A-class. The background music and reddish light gives you a feel of adventure. But you cannot watch this movie with kids, as some scenes are disturbing. But that was demand of the story. The movie does not fail to show the image of a late 80s dominance of men over women. Kansa in the film is quite slow in first half. Although the movie is just 1.5 hours long, at some time you feel it's a 3-hour film. The story moves slowly forward in time. I think that the movie could cover some extra details, but that was it. In my opinion, you should watch the film if you have a Netflix subscription. Your time will not be wasted. In the age of nepotism, trash remakes, you are getting a heartwarming original and conceptually right film. What more you want? I would give it 9 out of 10. If you have seen the movie already, you can give your ratings in the comment section. And if you have liked the video, then I would expect you to leave a comment below. So see you next week. Take care.